championship belongs to the Los Angeles Lakers.
Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers. We hope you had a very happy and safe Thanksgiving. Now let's get back to some Lakers basketball. Is head coach Frank Vogel on the hot seat? The Lakers did get off to a disappointing start this season, sitting at a record of 10-10. That's just 500 for a team that we expected to be a championship contender, currently sitting in the seventh seed in the Western Conference, which is in the play-in tournament. So is Frank Vogel starting to feel the heat a little bit? Well, Mark Stein on his Substack thinks that he is. Here's what he said. There is also rising buzz in coaching circles about the pressure mounting on Frank Vogel given the Lakers' worrisome 10-10 start, given LA's lack of flexibility to make roster changes. Okay, so for Lakers fans watching this season, this report is no surprise. Look, this team has been, let's face it, a frustrating watch. They've been all over the place. Up and down, we've been riding the roller coaster. We've seen some flashes of brilliance from them where they've looked like the team, the championship contending team we thought they would be. But frankly, those have been few and far between. We've also seen a lot of moments where they've looked completely disorganized on both ends of the floor. We've seen moments where the effort has been lacking. And this team, as Frank Vogel has said, is simply not good enough to do that. They can't flip the switch. They can't turn it off and turn it on right now. They've got to be giving effort a full 48 minutes every single night in order to get wins. And right now we have not seen that. And so some of that has to fall on the head coach. Some of that comes back on the coaching staff. Now, yes, there's other external factors as well. There's other things that we can blame this current situation on. Part of it is the injury bug, the fact that the Lakers have been missing LeBron James for more than half their games this season. A number of key rotation players have been in and out of the lineup. You look at a guy like Talen Horton-Tucker, Trevor Ariza, Kendrick Nunn. We still don't know when Kendrick Nunn is returning. Ariza is still weeks away. And both of those guys were supposed to be key rotation pieces. So Frank Vogel was handed a roster with not very many defense-first guys. And he's a defense-first head coach. And then on top of that, he had a lot of the guys he was going to rely on out of action. So we have to factor those things in as well. But still, even with that, the Lakers have not looked nearly as good as you would expect, even when you're accounting for the injuries. And some of that does have to fall back on the head coach. Now, once again, we can also say the front office, their refusal to bring back Alex Caruso, the decisions they made in bringing in players. There are all kinds of other factors. And heck, the players themselves are not blameless either. We've seen a lack of effort. We've seen poor body language, things of that nature. Some of that is on the players. But you know what? When teams are in situations like this and things have looked very disorganized on both ends and players have not played with the kind of urgency that they need to, a lot of times that does fall on the head coach. And so it's no surprise that that's what is right now in the rumor mill, that Frank Vogel could be on the way out the door. After all, look, the Atlanta Hawks last season, they changed out their head coach midseason, changed the trajectory of their season, and they had a great year. It is possible to change out your coach and have things work out. And frankly, it's the easiest thing to do. It's the easiest move to make. It's usually the go-to when you want to shake up a roster, where you've got a number of veteran talents and you want to shake things up a little bit, you change out the head coach, particularly a head coach that only got a one-year extension on his contract. So moving Frank Vogel is probably the first option if the Lakers continue to struggle. After that, you're looking at more roster overhaul, trades, things like that. But before you start moving players out, you're probably going to have a decision to make on Frank Vogel. Now, the Lakers did just win their last game against the Indiana Pacers. LeBron James talked about how they maybe stumbled upon some things in that one that lineup-wise worked out. So perhaps there is a path forward where Frank Vogel does stay as the head coach of the Lakers. He's been trying a lot of different things, a lot of things that are certainly outside of his comfort zone, including going to a zone defense. He's doing what he can to try to make things work with the roster that he's got. But if the struggles continue, at some point, something is going to have to be done. And more often than not, that something is a change at the head coach spot. But the question then becomes, is the grass greener on the other side? Because who are you going to find at this point in the season to take over for Frank Vogel? Is it David Fizdale? Is it perhaps Bill Handy who could take the helm? Or do you look for an outside hire? I don't know that there's a obvious fit at head coach that would be better than what Frank Vogel would bring. But again, sometimes just going through that process can wake up a team, can kind of startle them into action. And so perhaps that is a path that the Lakers head down. But Lakers Nation, I want to know what you think. How do you feel Frank Vogel has done at the helm this season? Remember, he won a championship with the Lakers in his first season, did not live up to that expectation last season. And now this season, it's been a bit of a mess for a number of reasons, but certainly the coaching staff deserves some of the blame as well. So give me your take in the comments down below. Don't forget, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel and ring that notification bell as well. Till next time, stay safe and see ya.